So today's video is about generics. Today generics are integral part of Java programming, and solid understanding of this important feature is required, and it is examined here in detail. Through the use of generic, it is possible to create classes, interfaces, methods that will work in a type safe manner with various kinds of data. Many algorithms are logically same no matter what type of data they are being applied to. For example, the mechanism that support a stack is the same whether the stack is storing item of type integer or string object or thread. With generics, you can define an algorithm once independently of any specific type of data and then apply that algorithm to a wide variety of data type without any additional effort. So the expressive power generics added to the language fundamentally changed the way the Java code is written. Perhaps the one feature of Java that has been most significantly affected by generics is the collection of frameworks. So the collection of framework is part of Java API and is described in upcoming videos. But a brief mention is useful now. So a collection is a group of objects. Then the collection framework defines several classes such as lists, maps that manage collections. So collection classes have also been able to work with any type of objects. So the benefit that generics added is that collection classes can now be used with complete type safety. Thus, in addition to being a powerful language element on its own, generics also enabled an existing feature to be substantially improved. So this is another reason why generics was such an important addition to Java. So this video describes the syntax, theory and use of generics. It also shows how generic provide type safety for some previous difficult cases. Once you have completed this topic, you will want to examine in coming video, which covers the collection framework. There you will find many examples of generics at work. So if we this topic is not covered in this video, whole topic, so we will make another video for this topic. So don't think this video is enough for it, but it's a big topic. So at its core, the term generic means parameterized types. Parameterized types are important because they enable you to create classes, interfaces, methods in which the type of data upon which they operate is specified as a parameter. Using generics, it is possible to create a single class, for example, that automatically works with different types of data. So a class, interface or method that operates on a parameterized type is called generic. As in generic class or generic method, it is important to understand that Java has always given you the ability to create generalized classes, interfaces, methods by operating through reference of type object. Because object is the superclass of all other classes. An object reference can refer to any type of object. Thus, in pre-generics code, generalized classes, interfaces, method used object references to operate on various type of object. So the problem was that they could not do so with the type safety. Generic added the type safety that was lacking. So they also streamlined the process, because it is no longer necessary to explicitly employ a class to translate between object and the type of data that is actually being operated upon. With generics, all classes are automatic and implicit. So thus, generic expanded your ability to reuse code and let you do so safely and easily. So a warning to C++ programmer, although generics are similar to a template in C++, they are not the same. There are some fundamental differences between the two approaches to generic type. If you have a background of C++, it is important not to jump to conclusion about how generics work in Java. So Java or C++ is a different language, and the use of generics in both languages are different. So let's begin with a simple example of a generic. So let's take a program to demonstrate the generic class. So here I am taking a class name generic demo, gdemo, and public. So let's start this program. So in this program, we will create a gen reference for integers and show the type of data used in IOB and get the value in IOB notice that, and create a gen object for string and show the type of data used for string object. So let's start this program. Oh, so public static void main string args. So create a gen reference for integers. So let's create it. Gen integers. Then next, creating gen integer object, assign its reference to IOB. Notice the use of auto boxing to encapsulate the value within an integer object. IOB new gen integer. So let's write this. Then here is edit. So next is show the type of data used in IOB. So IOB dot show type. Get the value in IOB. Notice that no cast is needed. So here int and v IOB. Then get object. Then system.out, we have to print this. Print value of v. Then system dot out println. Create a gen object for strings. Then string then string object and show the type of data used in used by string object. So string object dot show type. Then get the value of string object. Again, notice that no cast is needed. So string dot get object. So here is string, then system dot out println for printing. So here is we are printing the value of string. Let's see, our program is complete. So here is one simple program of generics. Here is class gen and this. So let's go to another program. Here is the non-gen functionality equivalent to gen. So this is the program here. And here is another program. You can observe the changes in this program. And this is here we are using two parameters. You can see. And this is a simple program of generics. And you can see this one is one program of generic and this is another, like inheritance. We are using inheritance here. And another program is bounds demo. So here we are taking a data type double and integer int. And thanks for watching.